Hello everyone. In the series of learning database management system, today we are going to solve few examples on ThirdNF, and we will see that whether the relation is in ThirdNF or not. And if it is not in ThirdNF, we will bring it to ThirdNF. So in my earlier video, I have discussed the way how to do this. I have discussed these rules also. And today I will give you one short trick, because what happens, students, when you will face GATE exam or public sector competitive exam, that time the question will ask you, check whether this is in ThirdNF or not. And you have to check if it is in ThirdNF or not. And for that case, if you are having multiple candidate key, then going conventional way, that first check whether it is in second NF or not, and then go to third NF, then you check whether transitive dependency or not, then it will take a lot of time. And time is very precious when you fight for competitive exams and GATE exam. So that's why that short trick I will be discussing here. This you can use in university exams also, no issues. So here, just a quick recap what we have studied for 3NF. 3NF, these two properties my relation should satisfy. A relation will be in 3NF if it is in 2NF, and there should not be any transitive dependency. So if I am saying a relation should not have partial dependency and a transitive dependency, then the relation will be in 3NF. Fine. If you remember, I have given you here one point to remember also. What was the point to remember? If non-prime determines non-prime, that we are calling as transitive dependency. If prime determines non-prime, a proper subset of candidate key, prime attribute, determines non-prime, then we are calling as partial dependency. And these two things should not be there. Fine. Now, your short trick came from these two points only. So understand what is the short trick, and then I will tell you how this short trick is helping and how this short trick is working. So here you see, a relation is in 3NF if it holds at least one of the following condition. So here we are having two conditions, and if any one condition satisfy, you can tell this relation is in 3NF and you can go for the next question. Okay. Or if the condition is not satisfying, you can tell this question or this relation is not in 3NF. So judgment become very easy. Okay. Now understand, if we are saying there is a functional dependency, X determines Y. So what you have to check? You have to check X is a super key. X is a super key means what? The element which is present on the left hand side. If you are able to prove that this element is a super key, your work is done. You don't have to check further. You can say this relation is in 3NF. Okay. And if this is not there, if this is there, Y is a prime attribute. What is Y? Y is a part of any candidate key or any key, then you can say that this is in 3NF. If any one condition you will find out in your question, you can easily say that this relation is in 3NF. Now, the thing is, you have to do this for all functional dependency. The short trick is not like one functional dependency you found and the deal is done. This will not happen. All the functional dependency, either it is following this or it is following this. As soon as you will find out these things, you can say the relation is in 3NF. So a relation is in 3NF if it holds at least one of the following condition for every functional dependency. This is a point to remember. Only if one condition satisfy, two conditions satisfy, and remaining functional conditions are not satisfied, then this will not work. Now, in few books, you will find this definition. Let me tell you how this definition comes. See, remember we saw this property, this point to remember. How we are saying that it is a transitive dependency when a non-prime determines non-prime, right? Here what is happening? We are saying if X is a super key. You remember what is a super key, students? Super key is a set of one or more attribute to uniquely identify a row in a table. If X, that means element present on left hand side, is a super key, that means it is part of a key, it cannot be a non-prime, and if it is not a non-prime, there is no chance of transitive dependency. So why I have to waste my time and I have to check further? Correct? So what happened? We are proving, somehow we want to find out that this side, this left hand side, if I get a prime attribute, if I get a super key, okay, then we are saying it is in third normal form. One more way, how we are checking? Y is a prime attribute. Now students, see here. Here you see, in both the cases, partial dependency and transitive dependency, right hand side, if it is X determines Y, this Y of right hand side is non-prime in both the cases. So if I prove or if I find out here this side prime attribute, then also there is no case of partial dependency or transitive dependency, and easily I can say that this relation is in 3NF, right? So hopefully you understood the trick, how this trick came. This came from those two conditions only. We are trying to prove that X is a super key or Y is a prime attribute. Now, for each and every functional dependency, we will do this. If this is so, then we are saying that this is not in third NF and we don't have any problem for that particular question. Okay, now let's solve one example, some practice questions, so you will be understand this thing better. So here is the practice question for you. So let's check. Here in the table format, I have taken the data. If the values are atomic for each and every column, we will tell this relation is in 1NF. Now, dependencies are like this. Roll number determines name and department. Roll number determines year. And roll number determines hostel name also. So basically, name, department, year and hostel name all are determined by roll number. So it's not wrong if I say that roll number, if I will take closure of roll number is my candidate key. Fine. Now, when roll number is my candidate key, only one attribute I have. That means prime attribute, if I will check, then prime attribute is also what? Roll number. Non-prime attribute, if I will check, then all others other than roll number, that means what? Name, department, year, and hostel name. All are non-prime attribute. Fine. Now, let's see the dependencies. Now, the thing is, roll number is alone. So, no subset I will get. Only roll number is there. So, roll number is alone. I don't have to check the case of partial dependency. Right? Still, how partial dependency happens? Partial dependency happens when we have a prime attribute determines a non-prime attribute, and that prime attribute should be proper subset of your candidate key. Here in this case, there is no subset. So partial dependency case is not there. That means this table is in 2NF. Okay. Now we have to check for 3NF. Okay. Let's check for 3NF. Now, here if we see roll number, a candidate key determines this, no problem. Candidate key determines a non-prime, no problem. Here also no problem, but here is a problem because year is what? A non-prime attribute. It is determining a non-prime attribute. So here I am having a problem. So what I have to do, this kind of dependency is known as transitive functional dependency. This I have to resolve. How to resolve this? So how to decompose this table because of this transitive dependency? First, we will decompose the table R into R1, and this table will contain all the attribute with candidate key which are fully functionally dependent on the candidate key. So this table will contain roll number as it is the candidate key. Then name, department are completely dependent. So name will be here. Department will be here. Year is also functionally dependent, completely functional dependent on this. So year will also come here. Now hostel name. Hostel name is determined by roll number as well as hostel name is dependent on year. So hostel name we will not accommodate here. Here we will only accommodate roll number, name, department and year. And for this table, roll number will act as a key. Another table because of which transitive dependency is happening. Because a non-prime attribute was identifying a non-prime attribute. So this table we will create for year. And who is functionally dependent on year? Hostel name is functionally dependent on year. So hostel name we will accommodate here. And we will make year as the key. So this table R got divided into two tables. Let me call this table as R. This table R divided into two tables, R1 and R2. And now there is no transitive dependency because as we divided, decomposed the table, and R here is acting as a key. So no problem of non-prime finding non-prime. Okay. Let's see another example. So here, let me take a relation. This is the second example. Here we have a relation A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, and J. This example we have solved in 2NF also. There was a case of transitive dependency, if you remember. But 2NF is not bothered about transitive dependency, so we just left it like that. Here now when it comes to 3NF, we have to solve that transitive dependency as well. So functional dependencies are AB determines C, A determines DE, B determines F, F determines GH, D determines IJ. Now, first, let's find out the important attribute, or let's say the director of the show. So A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, and J. A, B determines C. So A and B determines C. A determines D, E. A determines D and E. B determines F. So B determines F, then F determines G, H, F determines G and H, D determines I and J, D determines I and J. So which is the element who is not getting direction by anyone? If you can see, AB is the element who is not getting direction from anyone. So AB is the important attribute. If we find out the closure, because we want candidate key, if I find out the closure, AB will determine C, so I can write ABC. A alone will identify DE, so ABCDE. B will identify F, F will identify G and H, and D will identify I and J. So if I'm saying AB has a power to identify entire relation R, I'm not wrong. And that's why this AB is the candidate key. Okay. So now, AB is candidate key. That's why what are the prime attributes? Prime attributes are A and B. What are the non-prime attributes? Non-prime attributes are all other attributes other than AB. So C, D, E, F, G, H and I, J all are non-prime attribute. Now what I have to check? I have to check whether this relationship is in third NF or not. Now to do so, we have a short trick. So what my short trick says that for each and every functional dependency of x determines y. If I can prove that x is a super key, the element which is present on the left hand side is a super key, or y is a prime attribute. And this I have to prove for all functional dependency. If I'm able to do so, if all functional dependency follows that, then we can say that this relation or this particular relation is in 3NF. Let's prove that. Now, first see, this is a type x determines y. X is a key? Yes, x is a key. Then c is, if x, anyone, so x is a key, a, b is a key. Okay. Now, A here, A is a super key? No. DE is prime attributes. DE is also not prime attribute. So here itself, the condition violate. If the condition violate, that means I don't have to check for further dependencies, right? So what is happening here? This relation is not in 3NF, just like that I can tell. Why? Because here, A is not a super key and DE is also not prime attributes. They are non-prime attribute. So in this case, we are having the problem of dependencies, and that's why we will not check further. If we will check conventional way, that also you can see, if AB is a key, AB determines, and if AB is the key, it is determining a non-prime attribute, entire key is determining, no problem. Partial dependency, because A is the subset of the key, candidate key A, AB. So it is determining a non-prime attribute. So because of this, here it is a partial dependency. Here you see B, again subset of candidate key determining non-prime attribute. Here also partial dependency. F, non-prime, determines non-prime. This is the case of transitive dependency. D, which is a non-prime, determining non-prime. This is also case of transitive dependency. So this question is not in 3NF. In fact, this question is not in 2NF also. So what we have to do, we have to bring it to 2NF and then we will bring it to 3NF. Let's solve this question. We will decompose it. Okay. So how to decompose this? I'm keeping these dependencies like this, so it will be visible. I will decompose the relation R. First thing, first table, I always keep for candidate key. So what is candidate key for this question? AB is candidate key for this question. An attribute which is fully functionally dependent on candidate key, I can accommodate here in this table. So see, AB is candidate key and C is fully dependent on AB. So C I can accommodate here. Okay, next, R2. Now, this attribute is creating problem. So here I will create one table for A. A determines DE. So DE will come here. Now further, if you can see, D determines IJ also. So IJ will also come here. So problem of partial dependency got solved. But here still there is a problem, because this table I created for whom? For A. So here A wants to act as a key. But D is saying, I will also identify I. I am able to identify I and J. D also wants to become a key. So what we have to do? We have to further divide this table. So I am dividing this table R21 and R22. R21, I will accommodate A, D and E, and I will make A as a key. For another table, I will make D as the key. And D determines IJ. So IJ I will accommodate here. So this is solved, and this problem is also solved. Okay. Next, R3. So R3 we will handle this. B, which is a subset of a candidate key, is determining F. So B determines F. Now further, F determines GH. So F determines GH. Fine. So what is happening? Problem of partial dependency is solved. We are having another table for B, and B is determining another attributes where B will act alone as a key. But here F will create problem of transitive dependency. So this table also we have to divide further. So I will make it R31 and R32. R31 we will have B, F only. Here B will act as a key. Further, F determines GH. So here in this table I will have F, G and H. So here F will work as a key. So that's it. How many decomposition we got? This table R got divided into one table. This we will not take because we have divided. So 2 table, 3, then 4th table, 5th table. So this relation R got decomposed into 5 tables, and now there is no partial dependency and there is no transitive dependency. Thus we achieved R3NF for this question. Now let's solve one more question so concept will be more clear for you. So this is example number 3. Okay. Here we are taking a relation with P, Q, R, S and T. So 5 attributes I have. PQ determines R, Q determines S and S determines T. Now, first what we have to do? First we have to find out the director of the show. Let's see P, Q, R, S and T. PQ determines R. P, Q determines R. Q determines S and S determines T. Only 2 attributes which are not having any incoming H, which is P and Q. So P and Q are the important attributes. If I find out the closure of PQ, what I will get? PQ determines R, so I will get PQR. Q determines S and S determines T, so PQRST. So if I will say PQ is candidate key, I'm not wrong, and PQ only are my prime attributes. Non-prime attributes, those attributes which are not present in candidate key, not part of candidate key, so R, S and T are non-prime attribute. Now what I have to check whether this relation is in 3NF or not. What my short trick says, if X is a super key or Y is a prime attribute. Let's check. PQ, it's a key. So no problem for this dependency. We have to check for all dependency. Okay. Then Q is not a key. Let's check for this one. S is not a prime attribute. This is a non-prime attribute. So here my trick failed. That means what? This relation is not in 3NF. So what I have to do? I have to decompose it. Let's decompose. So if you can see here, PQ was my key. It was determining a non-prime attribute. No problem for this. But Q, which was subset of my candidate key, it determined the non-prime attribute. This is a case of partial dependency. S, which is a non-prime attribute, determined another non-prime attribute. This is a case of transitive dependency. So first I have to bring this question to 2NF and then I will bring this question to 3NF. Okay. So I will decompose the relation R. Always first table I keep for candidate key. What is my candidate key? PQ is my candidate key. Any attribute which is fully functionally dependent on candidate key. Yes, R is fully dependent on candidate key. So this table will consist of PQR. Okay. Second one. Q determines S. Now, Q determines S and further S determines T. So second table I will keep QST. So problem of partial dependency is solved, but here I want to make QS the key, but a non-prime is still determining a non-prime. This is the case of transitive dependency. So I have to divide this table further. R21 will have QS, where Q will act as key, and R22 will have ST, where S will act as key. So for this particular question, how many tables we got? We got three tables. The relation R got divided into three tables, P, Q, R, and another table has QS, and another table is having S and T. So hopefully all these examples are clear to you. That's it for 3NF. Thank you very much.